Welcome to my channel. Today I have a topic for you that is from black to white and now yellow fungal infection that is seen in post-COVID patients. So we have seen that in the second wave after COVID recovery, there have been a lot of fungal infections seen in patients due to unhygienic conditions, and that is why these opportunistic pathogens are taking its action. So let me give an insight of these different fungal infections that are seen in patients. So coming to the table of contents, I'll give you introduction of these fungal infections in detail about the yellow fungal infection that is seen, what are the common causes for this infection, and what are the various symptoms seen during this yellow fungus infection, and how to basically treat this kind of fungal infections. So I've already made a video on black fungus infection, that is mucormycosis. You can watch that for more details on black fungal infection and its remediation measures. So coming to fungal infections, I will also give you some details on the policies which include these kind of fungal infections. Like they cover these fungal infections within the health insurance policies. So that might be a need of the hour for those patients who are suffering from these kind of infections, and few takeaway messages. So as we all know, the fungal infections have been increasing, and the main reason for this fungal infection is unhygienic conditions. So we have to make this clear. There are a lot of cases coming up. Around 8,000 cases have been seen with these kind of fungal infections, and even steam inhalation is leading to some issues in home isolation patients. So that is what they have identified. Initially, they thought that these kind of fungal infections are seen only in hospitals where mild conditions because of not cleaning the humidifiers properly might lead to fungal infections. But recently they have seen that even with patients who are at home, these kind of problems are seen. So that is the thing that they came to realize, that it is not the humidifiers which is creating problems. Apart from that, there are something else also. And then they got to know that the steam inhalation is leading to issues, because we know that steam inhalation is good for killing the virus to some extent, but excess steam inhalation will create issues. So 1 to 2 times is okay, but if you do it 8 to 10 times a day or something of that sort, definitely you are increasing the humidity in your body. And when humid conditions are there, definitely the chances of these kind of fungal infections will be more. So that is what we need to analyze. Okay, and now we have seen a lot of cases with these kind of fungal infections. And just to give you some details, that these kind of infections is already seen in, was seen in one patient in UP where he was suffering from all these three infections, that is black, white, and as well as yellow. And recently he died because of this, because of the toxemia created, that is the blood poisoning due to these fungal toxins. So the three fungus that you can see here, the black, white and yellow. So these are the common funguses which leads to these kind of fungal infections. And all these kind of infections are seen in post-COVID patients. But not only post-COVID patients, other patients like people with comorbidities are also at risk. So we have to take care about their health, see to it that they maintain hygienic conditions, and try to save them from these kind of fungal infections. So coming to the white fungus, so these kind of fungal infections, they basically infect your lungs and sinus areas, and it can be identified through x-rays or CT scans. And the most important problem with these kind of fungal infection, the cause for it is the humidifiers. So these are the systems that are connected to oxygen cylinders which are used in the hospitals. And when these kind of humidifiers are not cleaned properly, and that means the water has to be changed periodically. If they do not change this water periodically, this kind of fungus can grow in that water, which can lead to issues, because when you breathe that oxygen, the fungal spores can also enter through the oxygen that is entering the cannula, and in that way it can lead to problems. So I'm just showing you an image of a bread, okay, just to make you analyze that how fungus can grow easily. So if you you might have seen this simple experiment which can be done, and to show that the fungal infections and fungus can grow easily in various commodities. So you can see here, I've just shown you in the left the bread. Okay, so you have to wash your hands with soap and water and press your hand on this bread and cover it properly and incubate it or keep it for some days. And one more, dirty hands which are not clean, and just you press it and again you store this. So can you see after some days there is no growth here, but here can you see the growth? So it is like all kind of fungus can grow, because we know our hands are prey to various funguses if you are not cleaning it. So that is why they are telling that please wash your hands every now and then, and all these kind of hygienic conditions has to be maintained. So this is how you understand that by maintaining hygienity, you can try to avoid this fungus to some extent. So coming to the yellow fungus infection, so this is caused by Mucor septicus. Okay, these are usually not seen in humans. They are all seen in reptiles like lizards, etc. So according to the doctor who found this case in the patient, he was telling that in his entire career he has not seen this kind of fungus that is growing in humans. So he was very much astonished by this, why this is happening. So this is basically the fungus infection. The yellow fungus infection, it leads to the problems in the internal organs. So it affects your body's internal organs first. So that is why this is considered to be the most dangerous infection in comparison with the black and white fungus infection. Because there you get the symptoms initially, you get to know easily. But here your internal organs are getting affected. So where you cannot see it. So that is what is the issue here, and that is why detection of this kind of yellow fungus infection at very early stage is very, very important. So apart from that, it also causes at later stages, there can be internal bleeding, there can be pus which is created in the organs inside, and there can be severe necrosis, and even later stages, it can lead to organ failure. So coming to few causes of infection, so basically your poor hygienic condition is the main culprit. Apart from that, not only your hygienic conditions, even the surrounding has to be kept clean. Like your contaminated resources, like whether it is food, the stale food which you are eating might be a reason for these kind of infections. And tap water, as I told you. So in humidifiers, they are using water to create that humid condition in the oxygen. But if tap water is used there, that might be a source for these kind of infections. And even overuse of steroids is one reason. Antibacterial medications. So when you take a lot of antibacterial medications, the good organisms present in your body also can die. This can lead to a lot of fungal infections. And other comorbidities and immune suppression is also a reason. And coming to the symptoms of yellow fungus infection, these are the few symptoms. So you can see lethargy, fatigue, exhaustion, and you cannot eat properly, appetite is not proper, you have weight loss happening, you have sunken eyes and redness, and if you're having some wounds, it does not heal that easily. So these are the common symptoms of yellow fungus infection. So coming to how to treat this kind of fungal infection, so fungal infections can be treated with only antifungal agents. So I've already given a brief about these antifungal infections or antifungal agents that can be used during these kind of treatments in the lecture that I've already given, that is the mucormycosis. You can refer that. But even here, I'm just highlighting because amphotericin B is the most important one. So that is widely used. And antifungal therapy, it is not a small therapy like your antibacterial therapies. This will take long time for healing. So apart from that, if you have any other comorbidities like this, okay, whether it is HIV, cancer, so these kind of patients are more prone to these kind of fungal infections because their immune system will be weakened, suppressed. So suppressed immune system is the main reason for these kind of opportunistic pathogens to attack you and lead to problems. So they have seen that in post-COVID patients within 6 weeks. So once they have got this COVID and they're trying to recover, within 6 weeks, these kind of infections have been more because at that stage, their immune system would be very weak. So that is the reason these kind of infections can happen in you. But in normal condition, these fungal infections are not fatal. It will not lead to problems. But only when you have this immune suppression, this will become a problem. So coming to how to evaluate this, you can easily use an endoscopic evaluation to see if this kind of fungus is growing in you. So simple throat swab or stool examination for fungal mycelium can be done. And this is definitely done by a microbiologist. So we require microbiologists here to do the endoscopic evaluation of the system. We require doctors and for analysis of the swabs and stool samples and to see if the fungal mycelium is there, we require microbiologists. So let me tell you something about various insurance policies also, which might be very, very requirement, which is required for the people who are suffering from these kind of issues, because they will require some insurance policies which will help them in getting this money, which they have spent in these kind of fungal infection. So definitely the comprehensive health insurance policies might help. And in the comprehensive health insurance policies, all the fungal infections like this are covered. Okay, but if you have made a health insurance which is very specific, like COVID specific plans are there, like the Corona Rakshak or the Corona Kavach. So these kind of specific Corona, COVID specific plans will not cover this kind of fungal infections. They will cover only the COVID related treatment bills, but not your fungal infection bills. But and you should also keep in mind that these kind of policies will definitely have a waiting period. So minimum 30 days of waiting period will be there. So this is according to the head of health insurance policybazaar.com. So you have to have this waiting period, and there are various health insurance schemes which will cover even these kind of fungal infections. So one good example is Star Health. So Star Health, they have already told that they have been receiving approximately 2000 COVID linked claims per day. So you can just imagine how many people are claiming this kind of insurances, because they have already suffered from this. They would have made these plans already. So out of which 90 are fungal related. So even fungus related issues have been claimed here, and they are getting benefited from these kind of claims. So definitely you should see to it that you choose the right policy. So it is better to consult your health insurance agent and see to it that you have the right health policy with you, so that when you have this kind of issues of COVID or the fungal infections, you can take benefit of these health insurances. So recently I found one more fungus is coming now, that is called as the cream fungus. So we don't know how many more such fungal infections can happen, but definitely if you try to take care of your health by having good hygienic practices and seeing to it that you take care of your health when you are suffering from COVID and post-COVID, so that you do not become a prey to such kind of fungal infections, you can save yourself. So normally what happens is our body has got good bacteria. Okay, these are good bacteria there in our body which help to eradicate this kind of fungus which is growing. Okay, in case it is attacked by fungus also, these good bacteria will kill those fungus. But what happens in COVID patients, they're taking too much antibiotics. Okay, because of this antibiotics and suppressed immune system, most of these good bacteria die, and because of which it leads to issues and fungus becomes opportunistic pathogen and they attack you. Coming to a few takeaway messages, we all know prevention is better than cure. So definitely we have to be vigilant, see for the symptoms, maintain hygienic conditions, and hospitals definitely have to take extra care. They have to clean the humidifier periodically, and definitely the surrounding area has to be cleaned properly. Hygienic conditions has to be maintained, and definitely too much steam inhalation is also not recommended. So definitely when you're using water for humidifier, see to it that you're using very clean water. Do not directly use the tap water. And definitely this is the kind of oxygen humidifiers that are used in hospitals. Basically they use this because the oxygen gas by itself is very dry and irritating gas. And if it is not humidified, what happens is it can cause lesions in the respiratory mucosa. So that can lead to some more issues. So to avoid that, they humidify this oxygen. So when humidification is done, this problem is not seen. But what happens if for humidification you do not use a good quality water, it can lead to other problems like this, fungal infections. So in Karnataka, they have tried to have a new discharge policy. So as per K. Sudhakar, health minister, they have seen to it that the fungal infection test is done in COVID recovered patients. So they are making this new discharge policy, which can be of some benefit. But definitely this is not going to change, because at that point they will do this infection test, but after the patients come home, if they do not maintain the hygienic conditions and take care about their health, they can get infected even then. So this is, to some extent it can help you, but you have to take care about your own health. So coming to how to analyze this fungus, definitely your fungal culture test can help you. So there, in case of fungal culture test, this can be done in diagnostic laboratories. So they do this kind of fungal culture test. So they can identify what kind of fungus is there in the sample. So whether it is a throat sample or the stool sample, using different samples, they can try to analyze it. So if it is a superficial fungal infection, that is on the surface, simple nails, skin scraping or swab test might be sufficient. But if it is something like yellow fungus infection, for systemic fungal infection, you may require urine, blood or sputum. So in this way, different samples can be taken, and then you can try to analyze if these kind of funguses are growing in your body. So try to be vigilant and hope that we do not have any more colors of these kind of fungal infection. So I want to tell you, please take care of your health and stay vigilant, stay safe. So these are the references that I used for making this PPT that I'm sharing with you. Please share this information to your loved ones. Do subscribe the channel for more updates. Thank you.